Hey folks, this is BestInSlot. Welcome back to Jurassic World Evolution 2 and a little bit more coverage of the brand new Camp Cretaceous Pack and Update 2, particularly the latter. Now, we discussed yesterday a lot of the very cool things that came along with Update 2, like all the new decorations and all the sandbox options, but tucked away, hidden away, slinking in the back, there was a lot of very cool little changes that, you know, really make the game a lot better in a lot of little ways. A lot of quality of life changes, a lot of updates, a lot of little things that maybe have slipped under the radar a little bit. So we're going to take a look at those today, starting with the single most important one. There is this one right here. Yeah, oh my god, what was that? Let's pretend we didn't see the legs there, okay? Wipe that from your memory. Now, why is this important? Well, because right here is the female Jurassic Park 3 Velociraptor, and for generations now. Okay, well, ever since Jurassic World Evolution 1, she has had red eyes, just like her friend, the male Velociraptor from Jurassic Park 3. Both raptors came into the game with Return to Jurassic Park, and they both had red eyes. But of course, the female raptor in the film has yellow eyes, and I don't know why that was the case for so long, but it's finally fixed. it's finally fixed. She has yellow eyes, just like nature always intended, and she's looking better than ever. One of the best raptor skins in the entire game. Actually, maybe my second favorite, next only to this lovely fella over here. There we go. So this is, of course, the male raptor from Jurassic Park 3, and the change here is a lot more subtle, but basically it's an increased amount of red around here at the top of the head and snout sort of area. Gives him a little bit more, I was about to say, a vicious appearance before he starts rubbing his head all over the ground. But that's a little change as well. It just brings both of these raptors a little bit more in line with their film version. The female one is definitely the bigger change, but this little guy is pretty cool as well. So this is what the female's eyes used to look like in the past. And they're pretty sweet, but they're not accurate. So also this red down here, I believe, is new as well. How you feeling, buddy? Feeling good. Forgot I was paused. Okay, so raptors have been updated, but we've got a few other pretty cool things to showcase. This should be a pretty quick video. I'm going to try to keep it nice and snappy. I am a proverbial lobster. Let's check out the next update. And the next update is for the Indoraptor. I've turned off the power, I've turned escapes onto high, and hopefully we're about to see something new. This was first spotted, as far as I can tell, by Mechaboy 42069, and where possible, I will credit the original discoverers over on Reddit. Are we about to see it? I think we are. Come on, buddy, you can do it. Mmm, delicious fence. Mmm. 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 I'll stop now. You know you want to. Oh, we're going over here. What are we doing? What are we doing? Yeah, there we go. So, finally, Indoraptor can also climb fences. Oh, it does a little Indo roar at the top as well. So Scorpios Rex, Velociraptor and the Indoraptor can now all climb fences. In the past, the Indoraptor wasn't capable of that, but considering we see it climbing things and slinking over so many things in the film in Fallen Kingdom, it makes sense that it joins the little crew of climbing dinosaurs. Still the coolest exit animation in the game, it might well be. So here we have an Indominus Rex. We also have a pack of Velociraptors. Now in the past, these two would roar at each other, they would run away from each other, the raptors were scared. And of course, a lot of us thought that didn't make a lot of sense. One of the key features of the Indominus Rex and the Velociraptors in Jurassic World, the first film, is that the Indominus Rex could speak with the raptors, essentially. It could communicate with them and actually turn them on their handlers. So hopefully we're about to see it, although she's decided to have a nap instead. I would like to point out though, whilst we're still waiting, that the Indominus Rex is actually part of a pack with this set of raptors over here. These three raptors, none of them have an alpha, as you can see, and they are following the Indominus around. The Indominus Rex is the alpha of the pack now. She's got the crown and they will follow her around as their leader. I think it's a really cool little detail. It looks like she's the parent and the kids are just, you know, fighting nearby, basically doing kid things and playing around. And she just keeps going, nah, I'm gonna have a sit down. Can't be dealing with you kids today. There you go. Very cool. That is our very first cross-species social interaction. It really looked like the one from the film as well, where they're communicating with each other and the Indominus kind of nudges and points in the other direction. The raptors turn around and then obviously they turn on the humans. That was actually really, really cool. Completely unmentioned in the hype or the build-up to the patch release as well. This is just another little thing they slunk in there to make it more realistic. Now, we've talked about this in the past. This is why I really like. We've talked about this in the past, that we thought Indominus and the raptors should be able to live together. Like, we thought that would be a thing because it makes a lot of sense. But then they go ahead and they even throw in their bonus social interaction, which looks really cool. You know, shout out to Frontier. That's a little extra work. And the animator did a beautiful job of making that look lifelike and like it's from Jurassic World itself. Good stuff. High five, everyone. It's just me clapping once, really, isn't it? Okay, something else I want to very quickly show you before we move on to the next bit. This is quite a small change, but one that's going to be immensely helpful. When you're placing down aviaries and lagoons going forward, you've got your aviary dome like so, you can place it down, you can see the circle. However, what you can now see around your aviary circle, like a beautiful metallic pterosaur housing sunflower, is these petals of circles. You know what I mean? So basically, you can now see where these circles are going to be when you place down your aviaries, and indeed when you place down your lagoons. It's actually really, really helpful with planning out exhibits. Any of you who've seen me playing this game will have seen me several times rotate, delete these exhibits to try and find the right place for the circle to go. But now we know if we put this here, then we know up here and up here and up there, but that's blocked, of course, and down here. Whoops, is it? And down there. You'll be able to know exactly where you're gonna fit those extra circles in. Might not seem like a big deal, but trust me, if you're building a lot, that's actually super duper helpful. Very cool to see. Okay, for the next change, we're looking at pack hunting, which has yet again been rebalanced. This time to hopefully allow your herbivores to sometimes escape from the carnivores. When I was doing the testing for the videos yesterday, I saw this happen quite a lot, but I want to showcase it properly now in the video with actual pack hunters. We've got our pro Ceratosaurus here, and what I'm hoping is they're going to chase down the parasaur office. They may even get hold of the parasaur, jump on it and do some damage, but if they don't have the damage to kill it and they don't have the stamina to sustain the attack, they'll stop. Now, in the past, what they do is they'd rest and they'd resume and they'd just keep going, and the parasaur would get away for a little bit, but it kind of keep on going, aww, over and over again. What should happen this time, aww, is that the parasaur will actually get away and the hunt will essentially stop. That will give you an opportunity to change things around if that's what you want to do. So, I will observe and see what happens. Okay, the hunt has begun. The Proceratosaurus is chasing down the parasaur. Yep, we're on board, they're jumping on, they're clawing, the parasaur's kicking, shaking them off. And they're going again. Will the parasaur get away from this? Will my video be pointless? Let's find out. They're going again. Parasaur, you kind of ruined everything there. Okay, but I mean, you don't want it to be a guaranteed fail for the hunt, right? So we'll just try again. We'll just try again, it's fine. Okay, here we go again. They're chasing down the parasaur. Took them a little longer this time. First one's just about got on there. Second one's sweeping in. Parasaur's kicking off. Parasaur is standing its ground a little bit here instead of continuing to run. Oh, there we go. He's trying to run there, actually. Actually did make an attempt. Kicks him off again. Is it going to run? It's taking its time. Parasaur's a little bit slow more than anything else. Shakes him loose. Come on, parasaur. You can do this. Oh, he's actually killed one of the Proceratosaurus, and you can see now it's beginning to run away. That still isn't really what I was looking for. but we're getting that. You saw it was attempting to run between attacks, but, yeah. Okay, let's hope for the best. Third time's a charm, eh? We've had two different outcomes so far. Let's see what this one goes like. They've had to do quite a run to get here. That is on the head, though. Bloody hell. Shake, parasaur, shake. And run. Why aren't you running? You're trying to run. It feels like maybe the Proceratosaurus is a little bit too quick for that to happen. It's knocked down, but it should be okay to get back up. The Proceratosaurus has actually hurt itself in this situation. Ah, I think this is actually done. Yeah, you can see there. Because the Proceratosaurus got hurt, they've basically stopped the hunt. The Parasaur should probably be running away here before just walking away calmly, but basically the Proceratosaurus has dropped its sort of stamina a little bit, and it's, you know, hurt itself, and they can't sustain the hunt anymore. And it's not just like it was last time where the parasaur runs away for a bit and they hunt it down. The hunt is over. They may resume again in the future. They probably will, because they've dying of hunger. But the point is, the hunt stopped. And that's a new feature that was not in the game before. Oh, I was also meant to credit, I do want to give a little shout out, the person who told me about this, well, posted on Reddit. This was OK Measurement 420. Good job, OK Measurement 420. Good job. Right, one last thing I want to try out. So this is one last thing. I haven't seen anyone post a video of this. I don't know if it actually works, but there was a mention in the update notes that some dinosaurs will now, whoopsie-daisy, will now charge oncoming pack hunters rather than running away. At least that's how I interpreted the line. So I think that's what happens. And to facilitate that, I've made a super strong Triceratops. The toughest Triceratops you'll ever see. One Triceratops to rule them all. And we've got three Protoceratosauruses. And we're going to see what happens. And I'm hoping, instead of running away, the Triceratops is going to think, you know what, I stand a pretty good chance here. And it's going to fight, and it's going to turn, it's going to charge towards them. Something like that. Like I said, I've never seen this. This was just in the update notes. So I don't know if it works. But we will find out. Yeah, actually worked. It wasn't a super big noticeable thing, but the Triceratops... Oh! Whoo! The Triceratops did indeed charge towards the Protoceratosaurus as they were approaching. Rather than running the other way, as we saw with the Parasol Office, the Triceratops was having none of that nonsense, for good reason, clearly, as she shreds the attackers with no problems whatsoever. Probably going to take down all three. This one has no interest in joining. This is the smart one. Oof! Trike, putting the work in. Bloody Nora. Now you can eat your dead friends. So it works out for everyone. So yeah, that's pretty cool. The Triceratops, I'm assuming maybe the Stegosaurs, or at least the larger ones. Ankylosaurids in particular, and the Ceratopsids, the larger ones, no longer run away from the pack hunters. They run towards the pack hunters. It wasn't like a big dramatic charge. It was just like a regular trot in that direction. But at least it shows a little bit more willingness to fight when they think they've got the odds in their favor, which is pretty cool to see, actually. And clearly she was right. So that's it from me. Thank you so much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. As I've shown, there are tons of little changes in this update, not just the big boy features. Lots of little really cool changes that should make our parks feel that little bit more alive and a little bit more cool beans. If you enjoyed the video, please do throw me a like, subscribe to the channel for lots more Jurassic World Evolution 2 content, lots more dinosaur nonsense, and just general nonsense in general. And I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.